There's no key, so you just put in a pin number. So it should be 1, 2, 3, and 4. And it's alive. Maybe I shouldn't have said the password out loud. Welcome to Translogic, I'm Jonathan Buckley. It's been over 4 years since we visited with Arcimoto, and rumour has it they've been having a lot of progress with their three-wheeled SRK. So we figured why not pop up to Oregon and see what's up. I'm here with the founder and CEO of Arcimoto, Mark Frohnmayer. Translogic caught up with you in 2011. It was before my time. Now, a lot's changed with Arcimoto since then.
In 2011, we just built our Generation 5 prototype. A few weeks ago, finished our Generation 8 prototype. It's certainly a huge leap beyond what we had on the road in 2011. And this is what we're actually intending to bring to the marketplace late next year.
So what constitutes a generation?
The generations themselves are sort of like broad vehicle architecture templates.
Right.
So when we count a new generation, it's really pretty much a whole new design.
So from the 7 to the 8 is probably one of the most significant changes, I think.
It's the biggest jump we've done from the beginning of the company. From the beginning, we've been shooting for something lighter weight, smaller footprint, something that really blends the efficiency of the motorcycle class with much more of the capabilities that you'd want for your day-to-day driving. So Gen 7 hit the road and was about a 1,700-pound vehicle. Generation 8 is right around 1,000 pounds.
Wow.
And that means, you know, lower cost,
better
performance in terms of acceleration, a smaller footprint, easier to park, and ultimately just less resource consumption for the vehicle that you use to do your daily driving.
Wow, the Arcimoto SRK. I've really been looking forward to getting behind the wheel. Wow, it had a wheel, used to have a wheel. Getting behind the handlebars of the SRK. It's the Gen 8. The last I heard about Arcimoto, the older model had a steering wheel, and by removing the steering wheel and making it a handlebar setup, it's managed to shave off over 700 pounds off the vehicle, which is then increased the range and improved the price. I guess visually, the first thing we notice from the 7 to the 8 is the lack of a steering wheel. You've gone with a new motorcycle design.
Right. It really shortens up the amount of distance that your legs take up.
I like it. So you've got your throttle like a motorcycle.
Yep.
You also have a lever, which is usually a front brake on a motorcycle.
Right. A three-wheeled vehicle has to have a foot brake.
Yep.
And so what we did is we put all of the hydraulic braking on your foot brake. And that freed us up to put pure regen on the handbrake.
One of the first things I noticed jumping into the SRK was just how plush the ride is in this. It's super, super comfortable. You just kind of like roll along. And because of the handlebar situation, you're quite close to the controls, so it's a super relaxed position. This one's got a top speed of 85 miles an hour, which in an open-air vehicle like this, I don't know if I'm gonna be super comfortable pulling 85 miles an hour, but nice to know you can do it if you'd like to. It's got a 7.5 second 0 to 60, so you're not winning any drag races anytime soon. But for cruising around town like this, oh, it's an absolute dream. And even in a cold Eugene, Oregon morning, because I've got the glass, or the perspex in front, the perspex over the top, all that cold wind is just sort of going around me. And it also helps with having a chat with somebody in the back, because you've got this perspex sort of cone in front of you. It actually feeds the audio back to the person behind you, so you can have a regular chat without having to scream or getting one of those funny looking communicators. We've had the fortune of driving a lot of three-wheeled vehicles lately. Some have two wheels up front, some have two in the back for various reasons and justifications. Why have you gone with the two up front configuration?
The design of a rear-wheel trike fights itself. You're either trying to shift the weight back in order to provide traction, or shift the weight forward in order to provide stability.
Yep.
But where we found the real win was to do a front-wheel drive, all-electric, two in front, one in back vehicle. You're shifting the weight exactly where you want it.
Yeah.
Right in between the wheels that steer and the wheels that drive the vehicle.
Okay, and that's allowed you to run dual motors as well.
Right. One of the things that was a big change was the shift to a dual motor front wheel drive.
Right.
And that gives us very precise control over the torque applied to each of the two front wheels. And so by having independent motors, it lets us do all sorts of neat things with torque vectoring.
Super stable. Because we've got the motors and the battery in the front, which has two wheels, it actually makes it really, really stable. So much more stable than a golf cart. And it's quite zippy as well. Tight corner, no understeer. Beautiful. So when it comes to stopping, you literally just feed in this super light region and you're getting all your power back. And it's so powerful that you don't actually have to use the foot brake.
And being a motorcycle, does that now require us to wear helmets?
It depends. So three wheels on the road means a motorcycle. The licensing and helmet requirements are state by state.
Compared to a traditional motorcycle, clearly this is safer.
Much safer. I mean, a whole different category. Yeah. It is a stable three-wheeled platform.
Yep.
It has crush zones in the front and back. It has a full roll cage. It has side intrusion protection.
One thing that's got us very enthused is the price of the vehicles. Your projected costs initially when we met with you guys was over $17,000, and now
right.
That's dropped significantly, hasn't it?
Right, from 5 to 8, we've dropped basically half of the weight. By dropping that weight, we've also significantly dropped the complexity and cost of the product. $11,900
wow.
is what we're targeting for the new base model price. The notion of the SRK was to be a product that anybody could afford.
What's next? I mean, we've got our alpha or our beta testers?
We're planning on building essentially about 50 beta vehicles, pilot vehicles, that will then lead into full production at the sort of end of 2016.
Well, it's not often that we get to revisit a vehicle that we've already tested here on Translogic, and I'm super glad that we've managed to come and visit Arcimoto and see some of the improvements they've made with the SRK, because they're really significant. Dropping the weight by over a third is a huge improvement that's affected a couple of other things. They've increased the range and significantly dropped the price, which I think for a vehicle like this is really important. For Translogic, I'm Jonathan Buckley. We'll catch you next time.